Amid continuing tension between India and Pakistan, a Pakistani drone was shot down by Sukhoi 30 at around 11:30 a.m. in Rajasthan's Bikaner today. The drone had apparently violated the Indian airspace near Bikaner at the international border. It was detected by the Indian Defence radar. With the opposition mounting a strong attack on the government, seeking details of the IAF raids conducted across the line of control on Pakistan's Balakot, Air Chief Marshal today said that the raids were successful. However, he refused to comment on the human casualties, calling it the government's prerogative.
If we plan to hit the target, we hit the target. Otherwise, why would he have responded?
ANI, please.
If he had dropped bombs in the jungle, there's no need for him to respond. Air Force is not in a position to clarify that how many people were inside it. We don't count human casualties. We count what targets have we hit or not hit.
Time, Savinder, please.
The bomb damage assessment that is done post a mission calculates the number of the target you've been hit or you've not been able to hit.
Air Chief Marshal also commented on IAF pilot Abhinandan Vartaman's health condition and said that his return will depend on his fitness.
Medical examination and debriefing after that depends on his fitness. If he's fit to fly a fighter, then he'll go back to a squad. If he's not fit to fly a fighter, then he'll become a low medical category till the time he gets his currency. And then he'll go back when he gets his fighter currency back. Because you must remember that ejection is something which is very... I've also ejected. It is something that takes a lot of toll on your body. And if you're not perfectly fit, and God forbid you have to eject again, you'll be spending the rest of your life on a wheelchair.
Now remember, Wing Commander Abhinandan has been undergoing treatment and checkups at a military hospital in New Delhi ever since he was handed over by Pakistan on Friday. His medical tests have revealed that he has a rib injury and a spine injury. Though the wing commander was not physically tortured in Pakistan, the IAF pilot has said that he was mentally harassed in Pakistan. Prime Minister Narendra Modi is up against a united opposition in the upcoming 2019 elections. The current political situation is a lot similar to the political situation of 1971, when Indira Gandhi versus everybody else was the circumstance. Indira Gandhi trumps the opposition. It is also very similar to what happened in 2004 when the invincible Vajpayee crumbled. So will Prime Minister Narendra Modi pull off a victory like Indira or crumple like Vajpayee? The Quince editor-in-chief Raghav Behel explains.
Prime Minister Modi, the mighty incumbent, is up against a largely united opposition challenge in 2019. Now, a similar political circumstance has occurred twice before. First, in 1971, when in an Indira Gandhi versus everybody else poll, she trounced a hasty opposition alliance. And then again, in 2004, when the invincible Vajpayee crumbled before a seemingly weak and incoherent patchwork of parties.
सत्ता का खेल तो चलेगा सरकारें आएंगी जाएंगी पार्टियां बनेंगी बिगड़ेंगी मगर ये देश रहना चाहिए इस देश का लोकतंत्र अमर रहना चाहिए
So, will Prime Minister Modi pull off an Indira-like victory or fall like Vajpayee?
Former BJD leader Bejan Panda joined the Bharatiya Janata Party in the presence of Union Minister Dharmendra Pradhan today. Bejan Panda had quit the BJD in 2017 after he had a fallout with party chief Naveen Patnaik.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi has come under severe criticism on Twitter for his comment on dyslexia during Smart India Hackathon.
Dyslexic बच्चे ऐसे बच्चे होते हैं जिनकी learning और writing pace बहुत ज़्यादा slow होता है, but उनकी intelligence और creativity level काफ़ी अच्छा होता है, जैसे कि हम तारे ज़मीं पर मूवी में दर्शीन रावल का जो भी creativity level था वो काफ़ी अच्छा था।
तो कोई 40-50 साल के बच्चे को भी ये योजना काम आएगी?
तो सर बेसिकली
तो ऐसे बच्चों की माँ बहुत खुश हो जाएगी
The comment has not gone down well with a lot of users on Twitter calling it shameful and in bad taste. The Queen's Chopal reached the city of Nagpur to get the Modi government's report card. We spoke to the people about a variety of issues, including that about their demand for a separate state of Vidarbha, farm distress, and the alliance between BJP and Shiv Sena. Listen in to what they have to say.
हाँ गठबंधन की जब हम बात करें तो वो baseless, senseless, visionless alliance है.
इन लोगों को अभी मुंबई और दिल्ली की हवा लग गई है. विदर्भ के कॉस्ट पे मुंबई दिल्ली में आप पावर लीजिए.
रघुकुल रीत सदा चली आए, प्राण जाए पर वचन न जाए. मुझे बताइए इन्होंने कौन सा वचन पूरा किया तो राम मंदिर का करने वाले
हैं. नहीं कोई मायका नाल ये देश में पैदा नहीं हुए कि घोटाले बंद कर सकता है.
उनको टाइम देना चाहिए.
Hello, Namaskar, Kasaka India. We are coming to you from the city of Nagpur, the city of oranges, the city of Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, the hometown of Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis and Union Minister Nitin Gadkari, the hub of RSS and the winter capital of Maharashtra.
The Kumbh Mela in Prayagraj will draw to a close almost after 55 days today. Lakhs of people thronged the Sangam to take a dip in the holy water. Temples from Jammu and Kashmir to Kerala saw devotees offering prayers in large numbers. For more news and updates, log on to thequeen.com. You can also like, share, and subscribe.